You are God, we praise your name. You are Lord, we worship you. You are God, we praise your name. You are faithful God. You are God, we praise your name. You are Lord, we worship you. You are God, we praise your name.
So, brother and sister, I just want to share this testimony with you. And actually, in my life, I was going to church. I believe Jesus Christ. But, Because you know, in the church when I was going, they always tell us, you know, we will be blessed, Jesus Christ loves us. And this way, for me, it's like, and when I go to church, whatever the sin I can do, I don't have any problem. So I was like hypocrite. I go in the church Sunday. When pastor say, you are blessed, I say, hallelujah. But after I finish the church, I will go upside there. I have double life. I will do whatever I want to do. And this, next Sunday, I will go to church and pray, ask Lord, forgive me. And, you know, I just turning around, do all these things. Because somehow I believe, you know, many times when the church, we always tell us, Jesus love you. Jesus will bless you. If you believe Jesus Christ, you will become rich. If you believe Jesus Christ, your life will be okay. All this kind of thing. If you give, you will receive. So in my mind, I was believe, you know, I believe Jesus Christ, if I commit all kind of sin, the Lord will understand because I'm just human being. And the same time, if I come in the church Sunday, if I give maybe the offering or I can buy something for the church, you know, all these things, I will be blessed. The Lord will forgive me. And that's how I believe. So I will receive it with my own sin. You know, I don't have problem with sin. I just sin every time. I can keep in sinning, and believe the grace of the Lord is there. Because, you know, in the church today, we always talking about, you know, how to be rich, how to be blessed. But they don't tell us how you can be blessed. Because the Bible tells us, if you want to be blessed, you need to follow the will of God. You can't be blessed if you don't have the will of God. So all this thing was going in my mind, in my life. I have double life. Sometimes I finish church, I will just go in nightclub. I sleep there, I come back, you know, in the next day. You know, all this, do all this kind of life. Until one day, the Lord picked me and put me in hell. When I reached in the hell, I was just in the gate. I hear how millions of people try. My own eye, my own self, I testify this. Million of people trying a begging for mercy. I was asking, what is going on? Because I just going, you know, many people was coming, you know, we are here because we didn't follow Jesus, because we didn't do the will of God. I would say, the will of God, what is the will of God? And million of people, they are there crying in the fire burning, some people in the darkness, you know, everything was pain, nausea, fear, all this thing was going on in the same time. And I was there. I just found myself, that's it. I just said, this is really life here. And then I look up. I see the house of God. I see the heaven. Because in the book of Luke 16:19, it tells us when the rich man was in hell, he looked up, he see Lazarus was with Abraham, where in heaven. So it came in my face the same. I was in hell, but when I look up, I can see heaven, and then I see people walking there. And then I was begging, asking the Lord for mercy. But I can tell you, mercy is only in heaven, because when you are in hell, well, yourself, you will see heaven, you will know mercy is only there, because people are there free, enjoying their life. But yeah, no mercy, there is a tumor. The devil is against that, and no hope. And the same time when I was there, one thing in hell is the fear. The fear is something. It's the fear because you don't know what will come next. A people, million, nation, country, kingdom. You know, people are there, a thousand. Trying million and million of people begging for mercy, but no mercy. I say, Lord, have mercy of me. And then the Lord showed me one of my friends. He asked me, you know this guy? I say, yes. And this guy, I know really, normally is a guy who was walking the street, preaching the gospel simply. You know, I would see him, I just think like, you know, this guy, I don't know what is wrong with him. But actually, it's really belong to the Lord Jesus Christ. He asked me, why you didn't live your life according to this guy? I would say, Lord, please have mercy on me. I didn't know all these things. I speak many things. You know, the fire was terrible. The devil, you know, we caught the head of somebody. In the head, we come back again. But pain, it will move your stomach. And in a few seconds, the stomach will come back again. The pain in tumor, a serious tumor, the devil was lapping. For him, you know, killing people, commit all kind of cutting the leg of people, the head of people. For him, it's like, when he's doing that, it's like, it's happy. For him, it's a passion. To do this is normal for the devil. So, you know, I can tell you this. And myself, before I'm sharing this testimony, it took me 2 years before I can become like a normal person. You know, my mind, my life, everything changed. When I was there, I see all my life, all the wrong thing I do, it was in front of me. And the same time, I'm seeing, look at up there, I'm seeing people, they're enjoying their life. That's eternity life we are talking about it. Somehow, and I was begging for mercy, but the devil against that. The devil don't want even to listen this. And that time I can't see the Lord, but he was talking to me. He told me, change your life. I told him, Lord, you give me the chance, Awe. Because before the Lord speak that, he already moved me, he put me, let her be, you know, in the gate of up from the gate from the hell. And then now, suddenly I look up again, I see the Lord was now in the top of tall mountain. And then the Lord moved me there. I was climbing the mountain to go to see God in heaven. You know, from then now, many people have been climbing the mountain with me together. So when I was climbing, and somebody was front of me, he climbing, he make mistake, he fall down. When I look down, wow, I really now see how the hell is a very big, and it's a very, very big place. A million of people they are there. And when the guy fall down, in the second, the body was like, you know, the devil come, it's so move the hand, leg, the stomach, the chest, everything was just like explosion. In the second is falling. I say, wow, this is serious. I saw people burning. I saw many, you know, people, they believe, different kind of belief. People believe, you know, all God is the same. But I can tell you, no, all God is not the same. The only way you can skip in hell is only Jesus Christ. If you don't have Jesus Christ, I tell you the truth, you will definitely go to hell. Because Jesus Christ is only the way. He said in John 14, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can go to Father except through me. That's what it was going on there. You know, I was see so many Muslims there. They was burning in the fire. I see some different belief. People believe. All these things, it just no hope. They are there, trying, begging the devil with torment people, put you, you know, they will be playing with your skin, move your skin, they will be do all these things. You know, fear, and you know, fear, it changed my life. Even today, when I think about all this, you know, whatever I do, I can never be normally. I mean, I can never, I always think this, my life is changed. So when this guy fall, I look down and see how the hell is big. A million of people. You know, I tell you the truth, you see. Even in this earth, I can tell you, there are few people every day going to heaven. Maybe it's just, let's say 100. Maybe just one can go to heaven. 99 all will go down in hell. Pastors are there. Evangelists are there. Preaching are there. Many of these things, they, you know, because myself, before I there, I was going to church and I have double life. Listen, if you are Christian, you don't live your life according to the will of God, and you believe by preaching or by serving, doing good job, he will save you, or by giving donation, $1 million in the church, I can tell you this will not save you. You can only be saved if you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior and repent from your sin, because the Bible is clearly, no way you can buy salvation. I reach there, I see myself, I know we can buy, it's not by, you know, you can corrupt God. He put there, repentance is more than any sacrifice you can do. So when this guy fall down, I see how the devil, many things was going on around there. I have boldness to focus in the Lord, because the Lord was in the top of the mountain. Because I see, I can, you know, I see how pain is going down there. Many things, how the devil is ruling people. It caused big trouble. It was eating people, you know, they will cut people. They will mix up everything there. So I just like, you know, I have more courage to focus in the Lord. You know, I just going straight in the law. I just focus and walk straight. And then I walk straight until I reach somewhere. The Lord just trash your hand from heaven and just pick me. And then I go up with him. So when I go up with him, the Lord show me holding the crack in the hand. And then he tell me, when you go back into earth, you go in the street and share the crack. Tell people to change their life. They are coming back soon. You know, myself, I said, Lord, you know, I'm no pastor. I didn't go to school. How I'm going to do this? He just say, just go. I say, okay, I will go. And then from there, my life changed. And when I come back in this earth again, I can tell you the truth. And the next day, I was born again. When I mean born again, it's not just 50%. I was born again 200%. You know what happened to me? The mind changed. First thing, I was like, I'm going to become, maybe I was speaking to people about Jesus to change their life, because I was believe that's the end of the world and right it will happen now and everybody will go to hell. So I was just in the street, I would just say, change your life, Jesus love you. You know what, I go in my life, in my own home where I was sleeping, I take everything, I put upside, I change my clothes, how I wear my clothes, I change, you know, my bed, I change, I put all everything, I put upside. I was fear, you know, every pain, anything in my life, you know, it would look like, I would just say, you know, put this one upside. I go in the market, I buy new clothes, new shoes, start from zero. I mean, all the past life, I putting behind my life. And I was born in the second. Many, because I know what I saw there, and this place is not the place. It's I will say it's not place to be. You know, most people will say I don't care, but I can tell the truth. You need to care about this, because Jesus was always preaching. He's always tell us about hell, and I'm telling you, the hell is no joke. And people are there. They are begging for mercy, just seeking, but they will not. They will always. They want to claim the devil put them down, cut them. And 2PC, they will come back again. They will be playing football with them there, you know. And the devil is very terrible. And you know, if something happened in me in the hell, but I see something in hell, you know. Most of the time in this earth where we are living, you know, most people, you know, if you worship them, if you see the movie, Hollywood movie, people are playing the game. And you know, they play in movie, they have all this kind of picture of the devil, but I can tell you, all this picture, the devil you see in the movie, in the game, they really exist. Because you know what, all these people, they're making movie, all these things. If you ask them where they get this idea, I can tell you that they will tell you. If they can be honest with you, they get all this idea from hell. All this movie, evil movie, all this you see, all this story come from there. That's the reality. But I can tell you, if you are in connect in all this kind of thing, definitely you will be found yourself with them. So that's how my life was going on. So I was in a big trouble. But I thank God because He gave me a second chance. I start evangelize every day. I'm on the street sweating. I tell people, change your life. Many of my friends tell me like something wrong with this guy. I don't know what's up, but only me, I know what is, you know, what's going on with me, because I don't really know what is going on. Because to be in hell, look heaven, you can see freedom. So I keep serve the Lord, I keep serve the Lord, because for me, I didn't go to school, I didn't study anything. So I just do what the Lord tell me to go in the street, share the crap and tell people He love, they coming back soon. So one day, the Lord come again, He visit me. And then, because I don't know, you know, I just tell you, you know, change your life, Jesus love you. Everybody, change your life, Jesus love you. One day the Lord came again and bring me now in heaven. When I reached in heaven, I saw millions of people, they was in heaven, they are enjoying their life, they was free, they was walking, they was playing. I saw the kid, I said, beauty, how the heaven is look cool, you know, everything was going there gently. And the Lord came to me. He told me like this, when you go back in the earth, what you need to do is always tell to people, for God so loved the world, that He give His only begotten Son, that whoever believe for Him shall not perish but have eternity life. That's what you're going to always use this. This is the bullet, the first bullet. I say, okay, Lord. So now I need to go back. The Lord tell me, go back. So now when I'm coming back, now in my home, I found myself, you know, I was laying in my bed. You know, I was laying in my bed. But I found myself too. You has just come from heaven, and one of me lay in the bed. I was asking myself, how come this is me? And this is me again in the bed. You know, all these things. But I can tell you, love is the spiritual love is more heavy, more than what we see. And suddenly, the Lord put me back in my body. And then, you know, I was very strange to just ask myself, that's how dead is. Most of the time when people pass away, we just tell them, we just say, you know, people die, but actually they didn't. They just, you know, change their life. If you are not in heaven, you are in hell, that's true. The body is nothing, it's just clothes, you know. When I come back, I just touching myself like this, in the bed, it's just like this, cannot move. But I was alive, I just touched myself, I said, this is me, this is my clothes, this is just like, you know. It's just clothes. It's not me. Just I was feeling myself. And then I keep serve the Lord. I keep serve the Lord. And that time, I was always see the Lord in the vision. I never have, you know, really personally see the Lord Jesus face to face. I mean, man to man, like we are talking. So I keep serve the Lord. Every day in my life, I just change everything. I focus full ministry, full-time ministry. And then I keep serve the Lord. It was one day, you know, I was when I finished evangelism, when I come back home, when I lay down in the bed and I sleep, and somebody was always touching me in the bed. When I turn, it's nobody. I was just pray. But then when I go back in the bed again, the same person will touch me again. When I turn, it's nobody. I was very scared. I called one of my friends. He came, we pray all night again. But when I go back again in the bed, the same person touched me again. And this time I say, okay, now I will pretending I'm sleeping to see what this man will do. But I didn't know this is Jesus. That time the Lord just wanted to introduce Himself to me as man to man. Okay, so I let down, He touched my back again. And then I just pretending I'm sleeping. And then I see it touch, because before in the old time I have operation in my back and my back was pain. It touched exactly where it's paining. And then I see and just touched there. It didn't do anything wrong. And then I just put my hand, I touch his hand. And then I see it's the hand of human being, but I can't turn. And then I say, who is this? Lord, is you? It's you, Jesus. He said, yes, it's me. And then he tell me, you want me to come to visit you tomorrow? I say yes. And then that's how I came to know the Lord Jesus. So from that, he said, I'll come to see you tomorrow. So now I go. Wow, I wake up now. I just stand up in my bed now. I will say, praise the Lord. So is it possible? Men can see God face to face. I say, okay. So I keep in the early morning when I wake up. It's the first time in my life I see Jesus face to face. I was in my room, the Lord Jesus just came down. Who is stay in front of me? I say, who are you? He told me, I am God. And then I say, Jesus? He said, yes. I asked him, the Son of God? He said, yes. The one died for my sin? He said, yes. And then I just relaxed. He came near to me. He said, how are you? I said, fine. And then, you know, people always think like, you know, when God wants to visit you man to man, it was being, be like shining, all these things. No. Jesus came, you know, he came like, I saw him, he's very gentle, simple man. And then when he came in front of me, and then we are speaking, actually he was telling me about the ministry. This is the first time in my life I see God face to face, man to man. Because we always say he rise from the dead, but you know the Bible says when Jesus rise from the dead, when he appeared to a disciple, some of them they don't believe. I'm sure many of you now will have this kind of mind. What he's talking about, see God man to man. But it's very simple, it's written in the Bible. So I'm just witness to you. But see what Jesus do. He came that day in my life. See what God, we, nation, president, everyone worship Jesus. But see what Jesus do. Jesus came. After he said, how are you? I say, fine. He go, he open, he take the basket. He open the, he go in the, in my kitchen, because I have open kitchen. He open the water in the basket. He put water. He bring the water. He put from, he tell me, put your feet. I put my feet. Jesus, Son of God, God, he use the water. He wash my feet. He wash my feet. I say, thank you, Lord. He say, no problem. And then after I finish that, he smile and leave. This is the first time I see the Lord face to face. Because before, I always see him in the vision. So now, a Jesus, a Son of God, a God who bow down to wash my feet. According to human being, they always make God, you know, is kind of, is impossible. But how many of us today can do this thing? I'm witness. You know, it changed my point of view how to witness people. You know, Jesus is a very humble person. We always say God, but if you really face Jesus face to face, you know, most of the time people are searching God, yeah, but it's in front of you. It's not far, it's just to search God in the simple way. So in this way, this is the first time the Lord introduced himself to me. And so I already know him face to face, man to man. So I keep serving the Lord. I keep evangelizing every day in the street. I visit hopeless people. I just do full-time ministry. So one day, the Lord told me, I was sleeping. He said, come in heaven. I've moved in my body. I start go up. When I reach up, the heaven open. I go inside. So when I go inside, it's closed again. But the same Jesus who come down and wash my feet, you see him in heaven, he's a different person. He was a King of Kings. But he came down. And then there was many thousands of angel people walking around. He told me, before I bring you in this place, you need to build your house here. And then he was with Angel Michael. So he called one of the angel, and he told him to show him where people are building their house in heaven. So in the same time, Jesus was walking there and, you know, around visiting the key, playing with the key. Just so the angel come, he said, let's go. So I was walking with the angel. So we walk and this, we reach somewhere, and then I see that this was written somewhere, house in heaven. And then I saw many people was building their house. Some are big, some are small, some are big, some are small. I was asking the angel, this is how the house in heaven? He told me, yes. He told me, you need to build your house also in this place. So I was looking the place where to building my house. You know, it was, you know, the Bible is true. Everything the Lord say is take, you know, is 100% truth. In this way, I started walking, then the angel showed me where to build my house. After that, and then something come in my mind in heaven. In the midst of people I see in heaven, one of my friends passed away a long time. I started searching for this guy. I called his name. I'm in the midst of people. I can't find him. I started crying. Somehow, and at least I see some people in heaven. I really know them. So, and I really know the good news. If you really believe Jesus Christ, you will never die, because my own eye see the Lord Jesus Christ. And face to face, whatever in the vision, whatever in this earth, most people believe God is living in heaven, and they believe the earth belongs to them. But I can tell you, Jesus Christ come in the earth every second he want. The day of the last day, we just open the eye of everybody to see him, because Jesus Christ want, if he want you now, if he want now, he will just show himself to you right now where you are. He know where you are living. So, but I'm telling you, serve the Lord in the simple way. God is not something to find him. Is serve the Lord in the simple way. He know where you live in. He will come. So I keep serve the Lord. I keep serve the Lord. In this way, when I was in heaven, one thing happened in heaven is, you know, the love in heaven is very, very beautiful, and people are very, and most people I see in heaven is, you know, these people you all see in this earth, they are nobody. I mean, they are hopeless. They are just simple belief. They just serve the Lord simply. But I can tell you, these people in heaven, you will see their property. You will see they are very great. I see so many people, they are there, they're just happy, they just enjoy. And then I asked to somebody there, please, can you come back again in the earth with me? This guy told me, you know what? I never come back again in there, because I don't want to go in this place, because people there, he didn't finish the sentence, you know. And then I was walking, I just see in heaven, I was say, wow, heaven is like this, heaven is like this, heaven is like this. That's the only thing that was going on in my mind, because I was very, you know, happy and see how heaven is, you know, and believe the Bible is true, everything is. Just say heaven is like this, heaven like this. And then I just been walking around. And then suddenly I come close to one woman. I was asking him, so heaven is like this? And the woman just tell me, this is confirmation. And then I wake up from my bed. Wow, I keep serve the Lord. You know, one day the Lord Jesus Christ, he came down again one morning. Before I wake up, the Lord Jesus Christ was already, that day it was already have, you know, some food in the plate. It's bread, but it's not really like this bread. It tasted like bread, but in another special way, and also some fruit. So I wake up morning, the Lord was there. We sit down, we've been eating this. So gentlemen, what I'm telling you is, serve God in the simple way. God is not far from us. If you really search God, you will see him. If you decide to serve God in the humiliation, visit hopeless people, share your food with those that can't help themselves, be friend with those they lost hope, trying to always make friends. Even the Lord increase you, trying to use this to help those that can't help themselves. I promise you this, you will not die before you face Jesus Christ face to face in your life. But remember, Jesus Christ is a humility, because you can only find him where nobody expecting he can be there. Most people, they always search God in the kingdom palace, and this way they always have this kind of idea. But Jesus Christ, who I saw in my life, we eat together, it was not. The way Jesus Christ appeared to me, even the clothes he wear, it was, you know, if you tell you this is Jesus, you will not is a comfort. But how many of us can be humble? No. Everybody in this earth want to start pastor, letter, prophet. When you do all these things, you miss the Lord. But the key is, if we can humble, serve one another. Jesus Christ died 2,000 years ago. But the Bible tells us, Jesus Christ washed the feet of the disciple. But myself, I'm witness to you. Jesus Christ washed my feet 2 times in my life. 2 times, a God who many people, nation, worship him 2 times. And I ate with him 6 times, man to man. So, this is the mystery of the gospel. But believe Jesus Christ and serve him in the simple way. So now I'm telling you, when you want to serve the Lord, don't say, I compare to this guy, compare to this guy. Always compare yourself in the scripture. Because it's only the scripture will save us. No one can save you. Myself, I'm speaking to you, I can save you. You know what I do? I'm sharing this testimony to you. Maybe you can use this for yourself. But your pastor cannot save you. Your prophet cannot save you. Your money cannot save you. Only the one can save you is Jesus Christ. Put your hope in Jesus, not in people. And you will see the glory of God. Many people preach, but they don't believe. Many people sing, it's a laugh, but they don't believe it's a laugh. Many people talk about heaven, but they don't know what is that. But the key is, Jesus said, I'll give you new commandment. Love one another. If you have food, you see your friend don't have, share with him. You have 2 clothes, you see your friend don't have, share with him. Live and love. Visit hopeless people. Make friends with those they can give you back. The Lord will be with you and you will receive all this blessing. So this is the testimony in my life I was having with the Lord. So may the Lord bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.